Well, we occasionally have a naan sequitur or two here, but today we're just having naan. We're making that delicious Indian bread called naan, and it starts out by just proofing your yeast here. So I have a half cup of warm water, about 110 degrees, putting some yeast into here. And what I hope is sugar. And just mix this up. Let this sit for a few minutes until she bubbles. So after a few minutes, some bubbles are going to happen from the yeast, and we're going to put in the rest of our wet ingredients, which is a quarter of a cup of oil, vegetable oil or olive oil, your choice. Third of a cup of Greek yogurt. And one egg. So mix these guys up here. Trying to break up the yogurt. And in another bowl, I'm going to have a cup of flour, and I'm going to put in some salt, a teaspoon of salt. And mix that into the cup of flour. And then I'm going to have a couple cups of flour that I'm going to mix into the rest of this. A couple more cups. Pour this in. And start to mix it in just a little bit. And then spoon in about a half cup more flour. And mix it up. And once that gets mixed in, do it again. So it looks like you add about 2 3/4 cup total. Then I got a ball here, and we put a little flour on the counter, and then knead this for about 3 minutes. Pretty simple recipe, pretty economical too. Nothing in this recipe costs too much. Then after about 3 minutes, your dough is soft, pliable, put in a ball. We put in our bowl, and we're gonna let it sit until it doubles in size. It's gonna take about 45 minutes to an hour. The unveiling of the naan. Let's see if it doubled in size. It exactly doubled in size. Look at that. Whew. That's a nice looking piece of dough. So I'm going to cut this thing in a few pieces here. 1, 2, 3. This is handy. It's my new dough knife. So I got these guys here into 8 little pieces. I'm going to roll them into little balls. Fold them into each other. Had one more of these, we'd play a little nine ball, but we're not. We're making some naan. That's the difference between pool and baking. Yes, that is the difference. All right, so now I'm gonna roll these guys out. This ought to be interesting. Make sure I have enough room. Put a little flour down in case it wants to stick. Think about it being naan shaped. Naans are normally a little long, and oblong is the shape they call it. Do you note that subtle shift I did right there between the larger and the smaller pin? That's the kind of skill you get here. You know, a couple years ago, you would never seen that happen. We would have continued to go with the wrong roller. So we're going to fry our naan. You know, there are options. If you had a tandoor oven at home, you could cook it there. I have a little acorn here that I sometimes like to cook things like this in, but we are going to just cook it in a frying pan in some ghee, clarified butter. This is fun. It's always fun to make bread. You feel like you're down to earth just a little bit more. You know, a lot of times we're not at earth here. Sometimes it's cooked like Bastard Studio. Maybe 2, 3, 4 miles above the earth. But due to the great technology we have here, it looks like we're right here on planet Earth. Ooh, that one was big. Consistency. Who needs it? The art of the Cook Like a Bastard kitchen. Never make two things look the same. I like about this, the oblongness of the shape is that I get a lot of letters. Oh my god, the letters say, your circles are never circles. Well, of course they're not circles. If you want circles, you have to go to the circle store and buy your circles. You guys got circle stores in your neighborhood? They're just putting one up here. You know, it's called the gentrification of my neighborhood. Oh yes, we're bringing a circle store into your city. So we're cooking this in ghee. It's clarified butter. You can make your own, or you can go at least to an Indian grocery store and find it. It's not that tough to make, but this time it sure seemed easier just to go buy it. So I'm doing this on kind of a medium heat. Put my naan right on here. And let the bubbles happen. There's a bubbling process that you're going to be seeing. You'll be excited by it. Trust me. You can see the bubbles are starting to form in here. That's a good sign that you're just about ready to flip it over. Look at that guy go. Go, Naan, go. Not only basing this what naan actually looks like, I've never actually done this before, so you're with me on this. Think that bubble's interesting? I think I turned it over too early the first time, but I got a few more, and flip it over enough, and it's going to be done and good. We're calling this one done, but we're going to try this again. There's enough ghee on it. Make sure my heat's at the right level. Don't let it smoke. I'm just going to taste this. Huh! It worked. All right, this is cool. I know what I'm doing here. I'm not some silly bastard that doesn't know how to cook. I'm not even a bastard. Okay. I think that's perfect. I have kind of loose guidelines of what's perfect or not, but if it's as tasty as that and looks as good as this one, you know you're making naan. Well, that's quick. That's easy. I'm going to put a little more ghee in here. We're going to make one more.
Don't get too hot.
So, we got the bubbles starting to form here. We know that's good. We know the ghee is burning a little bit. That's not quite as good, but we deal with it. That's kind of the way we are.
Glancing underneath, just make sure. Oh, yeah.
Holy cow. Holy cow. Check this dude out. Look at that. Look at that. Looks like you went to the Naan store.
I'm Naan Man. Naan Man. That's the man I am. I'm Naan Man.
I think you know what I mean, huh? So anyhow, this is what the Naan is. It's really easy. I'm going to be making the rest of them. We'll show you a picture of what it looks like when it's done. But this is great. We're making Naan right here at Cook.
Like a bastard.